Good morning. My name is Abraham Lincoln. I was the 16th president of the United States of America. You might recognize me from the penny and the $5 bill. When I was your age, I had 1 year of schooling. I lived in a cabin with my one older sister and one younger brother. When I turned 9, my mother died. My father took care of us until he got married to a woman named Sarah Bush Johnston. My new mom brought us furniture, beds, and chairs to our house. As I grew older, I became interested in politics. Soon, I became popular in a small town called New Salem. When I became a young man, I married a young woman named Mary Todd. Mary had ambitions to marry a man who would become president. We had 4 children named Willie, Tad, Robert, and Edward. But Edward died when he was born. Both Mary and I were depressed. Unfortunately, a war started. There was a civil war between the north and south of the United States. In 1860, I became president. Although I did not think blacks should be slaves, I did not support complete equality for them either. In 1862, I wrote the Emancipation Proclamation. The Emancipation Proclamation freed 4 million black slaves. Over the next 2.5 years, 180,000 freed slaves joined the Union Army and helped the North win the Civil War. After the Civil War, I delivered the Gettysburg Address. The Gettysburg Address was a speech I gave at the November 19th, 1863, dedication of soldiers at the National Cemetery, a cemetery for Union soldiers killed at the Battle of Gettysburg during the Civil War. Gettysburg Address went like this. 47 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent, a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation or any nation so conceived and so dedicated can long endure. We are met on the great battlefield of that war. We have come to dedicate a portion of that field in the final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this, but in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground. That brave men living and dead who struggled here have consecrated it. Far beyond our poor power, above our poor power to add or detract. The world will little know nor long remember what we say here, but can never forget what they did here. It is for us the living to be here, dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced. It is rather for us to be here, dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these under dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of people by the people for the people shall not perish from the earth. Soon I was at the Forest Theater with Mary, and a man named John Booth shot me in the back of my head and assassinated me. After I died, a man named Andrew Johnson became president. This was the life and death of President Abraham Lincoln. Questions?